I remember by Philip Larkin. Coming up England by a different line for once, early in the cold new year, we stopped, and watching men with number plates sprint down the platform to familiar gates, "Why, Coventry," I exclaimed, "I was born here." I leant far out and squinted for a sign that this was still the town that had been mine so long, but found it wasn't even clear which side was which. From where those cycle crates were standing, had we annually departed for all those family halls? A whistle went, things moved. I sat back, staring at my boots. "Was that," my friend smiled, "where you have your roots?" "No, only where my childhood was unspent," I wanted to retort, "just where I started. By now we've got the whole place clearly charted. Our garden first, where I did not invent blinding theologies of flowers and fruits, and wasn't spoken to by an old hat. And here we have that splendid family I never ran to when I got depressed. The boys all biceps and the girls all chest. Their comic forward, their farm where I could be really myself. I'll show you, come to that, the bracken where I never trembling sat, determined to go through with it, where she lay back and all became a burning mist. And in those offices my doggerel was not set up in blunt 10-point, nor read by a distinguished cousin of the mayor, who didn't call and tell my father, 'There before us had we the gift to see ahead.'" "You look as though you wished the place in hell," my friend said, "judging from your face." "Oh, well, I suppose it's not the place's fault," I said. "Nothing like something happens anywhere."